you should live is to live out or fulfill that purpose. It's fundamental. You can't play with that. Purpose. You have to live for something. You have to find why God made you. But remember that the earth itself was created on purpose. Purpose is discovered, not manufactured. You don't make up your purpose, you discover it. There is nothing that happens to you in life if you are purpose driven that will not add to your life. For a man that is purpose driven, there are no mistakes, there are no failures. Everything makes you better. Everything, everything. If you repeat the class, you become the most experienced member of the class, it's purpose. When they come, you'll be showing them the way. Okay? If you are purpose driven, there are no regrets. There are no regrets. Once you are purpose driven. And I won't take too much of your time, but I'm thinking to build on this, there are a few things we'll be sharing, but let me move on. So, what are you created to do and achieve? So it's called, you have to understand then the concept of time, which we've covered. The concept of time is that we have limited time on earth. We're not going to live forever. We're not going to live forever. Many people here, you feel very young, don't you? If you feel young, say yay.
Yay!
Exactly. But time is ephemeral. Time is fleeting. You see, the next 50 years of your life will pass like a breeze. You will not believe it. You have to understand time. Let me tell you something. 30 years ago, I did class 5. I finished from secondary school. Those 30 years look like yesterday. Because I still remember it like yesterday. Just standing in school, wearing my school uniform, not realizing that that aspect of my life was gone forever. But it's 30 years. So when you look at people that are older, you think, ah, they are old. They are only old in your eyes. They still remember their own childhood. So time, you have to understand time. Time. Time is an earthly phenomenon. There's no time outside of here. In heaven, in eternity. Eternity is a different dimension. So you have to understand time. The purpose of time is to find purpose in time. The purpose of time is to find purpose in time. Is to use your life on earth to find out where you were made and make the lifelong commitment to living out your purpose. Okay? So then you have to understand, we've covered this today, understand talent. Talent. I know that we talked about personality. So talent, what defines your personality is the uniqueness of your talent. Understand talent. That when you are looking for purpose, that to look for purpose, look to your talent. What do you have? What do you have? So don't think that finding purpose is so complex. There is a sense that is not it. Okay? And I give you an example. I shared this when I was there the last time. That my brother studied medicine. He's a medical doctor by training, by education. He studied medicine, but he's not practicing medicine. He's a financial expert. He works in the private equity industry. Why is that? Because God can use anything to train you. But don't confuse your training with your purpose.
Yes, sir.
Because training as a medical doctor will discipline your mind. I was a student in university. The medical doctors had the biggest books. Grace and Anatomy. They carried big books. Nobody can read those books and not be educated. Does that make sense? You can't read that. You don't, even if you fail as a doctor, you're not a failure in life. It will expand your thinking, give you a disciplined mind that can carry you through life. Let me give you an example of purpose again. President Jimmy Carter was president in America in the 70s, I think it was 76 to 1980, if I don't make a mistake. As a president, he's not a respected president. As a president, he was maybe the first person in history that publicly said, I'm a born-again Christian as president. Many of them were Christian, but he won his born-again experience on himself, okay? So he was very huge. He's in his 90s, he's a respected spaceman. So, somebody can judge and say, this man was not a good president, but actually he needed the presidency to fulfill destiny. So the purpose of the presidency was not to be the best president, is to acquire a global stature that let him stand anywhere in time and speak to any nation. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
That's purpose. Okay, then treasure. What is treasure? Treasure talks about resources, money. Okay, whatever you are called to do, you are going to need resources. So remember that beyond this class, everybody here must take classes in money. You must understand money. When you understand money, you don't, those that understand money do not chase money. Money chases them. Anybody chasing money here is poor, right? I know. Only poor people chase money. Rich people, money chases them. So just know that if you are the kind of person that you are saying, I don't have. There's something wrong with you, it's just that you're not financially literate. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
I know you're getting quiet.
Yeah.
It's a different class, but you need money to fulfill this thing. But money can be understood. Money is a tool. Money is a very good servant, but a terrible master. Okay? So, but let's go on. So, how do you find purpose? We've covered that because I listened to a great speaker. But I emphasize the truth is, life is a journey. It's a journey. It's not an event. So don't be desperate. Make the most of every opportunity, every moment. I mentioned that my brother is a doctor. It's a journey. He graduated in 1985 and realized that I'm not a doctor. I'm a doctor by trade, but not by calling. And so I may not be able to practice medicine. And made an early decision, like he says, to switch over to the world of finance. And he worked out and he found his calling in that process. But he was able to do that because he understood that life